Hello friends, this video polynomials part 8 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching this video, please make sure that you have watched polynomials part 1 to part 7.
Now let's do a generalization. Number of zeros of a general polynomial function. So if a polynomial function is of degree n, if px is of degree n, then the number of zeros is at the max n. That n can have at the max, at the most, n zeros. Also, odd degree polynomial function will never have nil zeros. This will never be possible. So if you're talking about 1 degree polynomial, 3 degree polynomial, 5 degrees polynomial, 7 degree polynomial, all these polynomials should have minimum 1 zero, minimum 1 zero. But if you're talking about 2, 4, 6, 8, if they're the powers of polynomial, the minimum zero is zero. Number of zero is zero. Correct? This is nothing but number of zeros. I think I'm clear. For a general polynomial, if it has odd degrees, 1, 3, 5, 7, if the power is odd, in that case, the minimum number of zero is 1. If it is even, then the minimum number of zero is zero. It can have zeros. And why it is so? Because if you take any odd, let's suppose any odd function, the graph will always be like this. The end point, if you see, it will be like this. One will go up, one will go down. So in that case, it will always meet x-axis. For example, if you draw a graph here like this, example, we have a plotted graph. So since this guy, if you draw more, it will hit the x-axis. So in case of odd number, the graph will always come out to be like this, where one point goes up, one point goes down. But in case of even function, the graph is like this. Both are going up, both are going down, this one. So if both are going down, let's suppose in this case, there can be a scenario where it will never touch the x-axis. If both are going up in this case, there can be a scenario where it will never touch the x-axis. So it can have zero as the number of, the minimum number of zeros can be zero. But in case of odd, the graph is always like this. So it has to touch x-axis. So the minimum number of zero is 1. But in case of even, the graph endpoint is like this. It can be like this also, if you see. Like this. It goes like this. Goes like this. This can be one function, polynomial function with even degree. Correct? Now let's take an example. We have to find the number of zeros of the polynomial functions. So let's take one, this one, first case. Here we see this graph is a line parallel to x-axis. This will never meet x-axis. So the number of polynomial, the number of degree zeros is zero. The number of zero is zero. This function, if you see, this line is going up. Again, it will never meet x-axis. This line is going down. It may not meet x-axis. The only point where this guy meets x-axis is at this point. So the number of 0 is 1. In this case, 1, 2, and 3. At 3 points, this line meets the x-axis. So the number of 0 is 3. This equation also meets the x-axis at 2 points, this and this. So the number of 0 is 2. This equation meets x-axis at 1, 2, 3 and 4 points. The number of 0 is 4. This line meets x-axis at 1 point. This is 1 point only. 2. This is 3. 3 points. So it is 3. Correct. What we have to do? We have to just see the number of points it meets at the x-axis. This guy was meeting at x-axis at 4 points. So we said that number of zeros for this polynomial function is 4. This guy was meeting x-axis at 3 points. So we told that number of zeros for this polynomial function is 3. This guy was never meeting the x-axis. So we told that number of zeros is 0 for this function. Now,
thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.